10:25. I was up earlier, like, I was, you know, my whole sleep pattern off, but I was up earlier in the bed. I went to sleep early last night because being out all day, I was out all day. I was tired. Because then, what's the strain? That was what? Cookies and Cream by Jungle Boys. Oh, my God. Wonderful. So, yeah, I was knocked out. It was great because, yeah, beautiful thing. 10:26 right now at work. Trying to knock out these two tasks. Then go do grocery shopping. For the folks. I did mine yesterday. I'm going to go out and do theirs. These mattress people, I told them between 11 and 5. But, you know, I have not yet, have yet to speak to the manager. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go out and run the errands. After I finish my errands, I am going to call there to see what is the update, because they haven't said that the mattress got to the location here in Brooklyn. You know, I don't like this run around. And then I got my parents in my ear. This is annoying. Like, yo, get this freaking mattress here. I'm annoyed. And it's starting to really tick me off.
I'm a vlogger, a video blogger.
I need to cut my nose hairs. But I've been leaving it because I'm like, you know, any sprinklets of the COVID, it could stay on my nose hairs and I blow it out. What's up, y'all? 10:58, I'm outside now, about to go do the parents' grocery shopping. Spoke to the furniture people. Yeah, I'm about to go on my phone charge. I'm going to go on Google and Yelp, and I'm going to leave my review of your fuckery. So I called them, and you know, I finally speak to the manager that was there when the initial purchase, and I expressed my pissed offness, saying like, yo, I shouldn't have to be constantly reaching out to find out what's going on with this delivery. Mind you, when we first came there, you said, all right, boom. They said it's going to come to them Thursday, but let's shoot for Friday. Cool, no problem. Once you know that it's not going to happen on a Friday, you should reach out to the customer and let them know, not on the Friday, but the Thursday when you found out. Boom. All right, so find out from you. When I called you on the Thursday to find out the window for the Friday, that's when you tell me, oh, it's not going to be coming until sometime next week. Sometime next week doesn't help. Give me a day. At least give me a day. You don't have a day. So that's good? That's good? We are now back to Friday. So I told them, I forgot, I don't have the paper, but their slogan is something about comfort is our goal. I said, comfort is your goal. And so far, this experience has not been comfortable. Oh, I'm sorry. Da, 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 da. I'm like, these are senior citizens that came to you. I'm like, you don't treat people like this. And they say, it's not like we owe you money. We paid for this in cash. Oh, I didn't say we owe you money. I said, I know you didn't say that. I'm telling you, we don't owe you money. So you acting like people that owe you money got some shit on layaway. Nigga, look. Oh, we're not running away for the amount the mattress cost. I'm saying it could have been $5. It's still my money. Listen. Listen. 11:10. Yep, I sat in my garage, in my driveway, and wrote that, you know, while it's in my head clear, sat there and wrote my Yelp review. I gave them 2 stars, and then I wrote my whole, don't play with me. Don't play with me. I'm very big, if you're watching me, I'm very big on customer service. Very big on it. Again, like I said to the dude on the phone, you can't control the warehouse. I get that, no problem. But you can't control how you treat your customers. Where am I going? I don't want to go this way. I want to go further. That's my whole thing. You can't control how you treat your customer. That's all I'm asking. You know, shit happens. I get it. But you need to know how to treat your customers. So, yeah, eat that Yelp review, you fucktard. Right now, before I go to Sumogan, I need to get some Epsom salt, alcohol. What are you doing? Why are you riding? There's a bicycle, someone on this, like, what the hell are you driving like? I see people with like the fanciest cars drive so stupid. It's like, you must have money to waste. Yeah, I need to go get Epsom salt, alcohol. Cause what I have there is 50% in the house. I need one, it says 90% or higher. Where's the store's on this? I go, yeah. And yeah, that's what I need, because I need to clean my bong. They have stuff that you could clean it with, but I don't know what them chemicals are. I'd rather stick with some Epsom salt and some the alcohol and clean my bong, because it's gross. and I need to buy a bonnet. I don't like the stocking cap on my head. I don't like weight. Yeah, because the last journey, I didn't use stocking caps. Oh, I did for a period of a little short time. Then I was like, nah, switch over to the satin bonnet. Yeah, it's better for my hair. So I'm gonna pick that up. It's nice out here, not bad. 84, but it's not really humid. Come on, Infinity. You feel me? Drive your shit. Look at this asshole. Look at him. Stupid fucker. Could you move over? You stupid. Take one fucking lane, you fucktard. I don't like stupid. What the fuck? Yes, we see you have an Infinity. Drive in one lane, you fucking idiot. I just don't like stupidness. Like, this is not a car show. You got a nice car. Can we get it? Niggas driving in the middle of the road, just chilling. No. All right, 11:28. I got what I needed. When I went in there, in the aisle, I saw the alcohol and the Epsom salt. Again, it was only 50%. I'm like, why is this everyone 50%? But they have the 90% one that was in the front. So I'm glad I looked in the front. So yeah, we're gonna clean the bong together. And I got that, the Epsom salt, the alcohol, and I got three bonnets. Yeah. Yeah, they didn't have no black ones. I'll show you that when I get in. Anyway, now it's time to go do grocery shopping. I was like trying to decide what supermarket I wanted to go to.
I got everything on my parents' list except fucking snow peas. It's like, oh, funny. To the supermarket, but I was like, there's a green grocer. Oh, fuck, mask.
before all done. I was gonna go to a supermarket. Well, you saw I went to the green grocer. I don't know if that's the hell you call it. I don't go to them places, you know, because I don't buy vegetables like that. Whatever. I buy frozen shit. Whatever. But yeah, smart move going in there. She, my mom asked for two. I got three. You know, let it last. Whatever. So groceries done. Head home. I need a wonderful shower. Oh God, I just.
So I got a purple one, a red one, and a blue one. They're $23 each. Epsom salt and the rubbing alcohol. Yeah. Time to feed my face. Oh, it is. Alexa, what time is it?
It's 1:28 p.m.
It's the first thing I've eaten all day.
Have a good afternoon.
Why you don't say my name no more?
Yeah, I'm all in. Brody on the line, I'm tapping in. Got out here pulling the strings for me. A girl on the line, she feeling me. Preoccupied by the motivation. Put in the time, pay the entry fee. Bro on the ride, yeah, he kinda nice. Inside of my mind, no one's real as me. Lately, life has been gorgeous. Wake up the clear, my eyes hit record. Praise up to God, I ain't chasing no bitch. Swinging the miss, got me hitting these licks. I get the orders, don't get it distorted. Disconnected, I've been coreless, I've been cordial, I've been exploring. I got a whole lot, but somehow I want more of it. Yeah, I want a tour and put on for the soil. Hey, bruh, remember they used to ignore us? Now they drop me the pin with the cord and they catch me running through the ordinance. Remember we couldn't afford the whip. Pushing and scraping, that shit was so ageless. We blowing on grapes for the flavors. All of a sudden we major, still independent but no label. For now I'm going hard enough that the streams will lead to a house by the beach. All of this done with the speech. Filling my pockets for now, but later I want the picket for some sign of the neighbors. I used to skip out on the payments. Nowadays I tax for the labor. Dog on the line, you ain't tapping in. I'm staying clear, fake rapper friends. Kamikaze on a traffic cam. Only one shot to navigate the labyrinth. I'm keeping it late, burn it down to the ash. My life ain't much more than imagine. I got where I'm at with the passion. Traded all to live it backwards. Pray we ain't make it through the night. Hope we ain't make it through the night. You can see it. When you look into my eyes. When you look into my eyes. You can see that I'm crying all day. I've been going my way.
I don't know why I didn't do this a long time ago. I am so amazed at how it's clean. Oh my God. Oh my God. It is beautiful. Now I know Epsom salt, alcohol. Oh, this water.
Yeah. I'm elevated, overeducated. I run the race for who I resonate with.
So they just called me and said that the mattress is ready for delivery. So I'm about to go to my folks. They'll ask me, what's the address? I said, you don't have the bill? This is...
done. They got the, you know, the mattress and stuff. But I have to go now. I didn't come out to do this specifically, but I got to get a cover because you can't put the mattress out there like that, you know, somebody, you know, spread of bed bugs, you know, whatever. Yeah, so I have to, hopefully they have it at this store. But you know what pissed me off? I'm just glad it's over. And I went and I adjusted my Yelp review. We paid also to have the mattress removed. This ain't my first rodeo. Had many mattresses, had to pay for them to remove, and they take the mattress. So first, you know, they came and they put the new one up in the wall, and they're looking at me, and I'm like, we paid for the mattress to be removed. Oh, we didn't know that. So once again, this is being unprepared, not organized, because you're sending someone out to deliver something, they should have all of the information. You understand? They should have all of the information.
So he had to call his boss on it. Then when he called in there, he called a number. He getting the same thing like how I was having the voicemail, and he get pick up voicemail. So he must have called another number and got his somebody. Because then while he was on the phone, I called a number to talk to them. Me like, you know, we pay for the removal of the mattress. You know, what's the problem? So they said, yeah, okay, you'd pay for it. But you know, they just taking it out to, just taking it outside. What the fuck am I paying for? And the fact that nigga got on the phone to call, like if they were going to take it, you know, like how you're supposed to do removal, you just taking that shit outside and you calling to see if we pay for you to take the shit outside? Nigga, please. Bruv. I tell you, customer service goes a long way. Goes a long way. When I was speaking to the guy on the phone, yeah, we remove it out into the where you put your garbage. I said that wasn't said, because had that been said, we wouldn't have paid for removal. I would have dragged that shit out myself, bro. So they drag it out. I was just so annoyed, so pissed, and then my parents were getting on my nerves too. Like, yo, oh my god, I'm just glad this shit is over. I'm over it.